Hey, welcome back to the channel. I'm Dr. Justin Feldman from Feldman Physical Therapy and Performance. And today we're going to talk a little bit about zone two training and zone two workouts. And when we try to talk to athletes about the benefits of zone two training, the first pushback that we get from everybody is, but I need to go harder. I need to work harder. It doesn't feel hard enough. And today we're going to try and explain why that's exactly how it's supposed to feel and how that will benefit you. So when we talk about zone two training, we know we want it to feel easy. If we were to break your zones up into five zones, right? Zone one, two, three, four, and five, we want you to stay in that lower part of the range. So we're looking at that zone two, and we're looking at maybe a little bit creeping into the bottom of zone three. But the idea and the reason for doing this is it helps you build your aerobic engine. It helps make your body more efficient. It can actually help your body build more mitochondria. It can help with recovery. It can help with metabolism. There are tons of benefits here. One of the keys though is the zones that you're using need to be designed for you, and they also need to be designed for the sport that you're doing. So we'll start with the second part first. The sport that you're doing. So if you are going to be cycling, those are going to be different zones that you're going to be using than if you're running. And a lot of times cycling people might even get into using power zones instead. But when we're talking about this, one of the mistakes that people will make is they'll say, okay, these are my heart rate zones and go. And it does need to be changed a little bit for each sport. The other thing is that all of these fitness devices that everybody wears, these watches, whether it's a Garmin watch, whether it's a Coros watch, whether it's an Apple watch, they all have different algorithms that they use to try to guess what your heart rate zones are going to be. And you'll see it, you'll finish a workout, you'll hit the button, it'll say, do you want to accept these new zones? Do you want to change them? And they're sort of okay for most people, but they're great for nobody. And so they try to do this because they want to avoid having to make you take a heart rate zone test, because the heart rate zone tests are hard, they're not fun, and they know that a lot of people probably wouldn't do them. And the thing here is you kinda gotta do it. If you're gonna be doing this kind of training and you're gonna dedicate the time to it, we want you to have accurate numbers. And so doing that heart rate zone test for each sport is a really important step in the process of getting this right. All right, so we're coming down to the ground here. A little quick interruption with Toby. If you're finding this helpful, then we'd really appreciate it if you shared it around with your friends, subscribe to the channel. Helps us grow and helps us be able to help more people. We did do a couple years ago, we did a good video, and I'll link to that up above here, where we had John run through a full heart rate test, and we actually described how to calculate the zones from within that. And so we'll link that video up here. But generally what we're trying to do is we're trying to get you to work at a maximal effort, and then we're gonna do it for a set period of time, and then we're gonna do some math off of there, and we're gonna figure out where those different heart rate zones are. Now, when we're doing this zone two training, right, figure you have 100% of your training, and so we're gonna divide it up, and we wanna try and get about 70 to 80% of your training in that zone two range, and then we wanna try to get the other 20 to 30% sort of in zone four, five, or around that ratio if we can do it. And so that doesn't mean that your whole workout necessarily has to be in zone two. In fact, a lot of times when I program workouts for athletes, I like to have some little bits in the middle where it might be a little bit harder. And so we might try to push them out of zone two and then get them into those zone four, zone five efforts, and then have them work on their recovery to come back down. And this too, that sort of like cycling in and out, can also help build efficiency and help your body sort of build the ability to recover from those harder efforts and come right back in to that zone where we want it. And it is something where in the beginning, it might take you longer to recover. And so people often will say, oh man, but you know, I did this, but I had to walk for this much time, and it doesn't matter, right? We only care about where you are in those zones. We don't necessarily really care as much about what you're doing to stay in those zones. So the other thing to think about when we look at this zone two training is the terrain that you're on. So if you're finding yourself on a lot of hilly terrain, let's say, and you're running, right, it might be a lot harder to stay in zone two and still run. And on the flip side, let's say you're on a lot of hilly terrain and you're cycling, right? You might have to work hard on some of those downhills to keep your heart rate in that zone two and not let it sort of drop down into that zone one or into that sort of like recovery zone. So that's something that we want you to think about, is the terrain and where you're kind of going to do the workout. The other thing is we want to look at where you're getting your data. And so the watches, they're great, right? But those heart rate sensors on the back of the watch, they're not always the most accurate. And so they can be a little bit challenging at times, especially for some people, depending upon skin tone, how tight you like to wear your watch, any of that stuff. And so we really recommend either the chest strap or optical armband. And those are kind of like the gold standard. And if you're finding that you really want to spend the time to invest in this kind of training, then making sure you're getting good data is really important. The other thing we'll see with the heart rate on the watch is it doesn't tend to be as responsive. So if you're doing maybe 3 minutes at a higher zone and then recovering, it might take the watch a little bit longer to register that recovery and come back down. And so you might think your heart rate's still up and it's really right back where it should be. So paying attention to the terrain as well as paying attention to the equipment that you're using are really important to get the most out of your zone two training. All right, so you're sold on this, and now we got to figure out how to get you to implement this into your training. So I will say, right, shameless plug, I definitely recommend trying to get a coach because it will help you in a few ways. One, it saves you from having to do all the programming and the math, and they can sort of figure out where you are and what sort of workouts are working for you. And you wake up, you look at your workout that they have planned for the day, and all you kind of have to do is execute it. On the flip side, if you're saying, no, I really want to kind of like go at this on my own, then basically if you're going to have 5 workouts in a week, right, we want you to spend maybe 3 of those workouts should be pretty easy conversational pace. You can hold a conversation and you're going to spend most of the time in those workouts in that zone two. And then you've got 2 other workouts where we want you to push yourself and challenge yourself a little bit. And those workouts might be more interval style workouts. So we don't really want you to sit in that zone four, zone five for an entire workout, right? The idea might be trying to build up your tolerance for time in those higher zones, but giving yourself the 2 to 3 minutes of recovery in between. And I like to use a rule of, as the efforts get harder, I want to try and give the athletes equal work to rest ratios. So if you're doing a 3 minute hard effort, I like you to have a 3 minute recovery to let that heart rate come back down. If we start to find that your heart rate is not coming back down in enough time, then we might even lengthen that out. And if you're somebody who seems to come back down pretty well, then maybe as your training progresses, we can start to shorten some of those recoveries. But that's what we have for you on zone two training. And I'd love to see what questions people have, hear your experience with zone two training. So if you've got questions, something you wanna see, definitely jump down in the comments, throw it below. If you found this helpful, make sure you subscribe to the channel and we'll see you back here soon.